time for the teams to come out onto court.
The world champion, the Star Champions 2018, the team of the year 2019. Player number one, Rio Olympian, best blocker, 2015, 17, and 19. 1 meter 96 tall, 34 years old, with 6 career wins.
That comes Sarah Pavan, the blocker, the left-hander, one of the most difficult players to deal with on the tour. And out comes the defender, Melissa Jimena Paredes. $346,000 in prize money in her career. Sarah Pavan with just short of $500,000.
Brazil, World Tour Final Champions 2018. Player number one, World Champion 2015. Rio Silver Medalist 2016. 38 years old, 182 tall. Tournament number 135. 10 career wins. Please welcome Agata!
What a record she has, Agata. 135 tournaments, a Rio silver medal, World Tour finalist, World Tour champion in 2018, and a silver medal in 2019 with her partner Duda. And out comes Duda, just 22, and you get the feeling she's going to be looking for another partner after this Olympic Games comes to an end, after this tournament, certainly after the season, as they start to build again. But right now, though, Agata in such good form at 38 years of age, you wouldn't bet on her not going for a few more years just yet. Well, I hope you're sitting comfortably, wherever you're watching from, whatever you're watching on, this is about to get going. Canada in red, serving Brazil, receiving, wearing all blue. This, the first semi-final of the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour event here in Stade, Switzerland. First point goes the way of Brazil. Duda will serve. Agata going to stay at the net and block. Going after Melissa Jimena Paredes, who gets her side out very comfortably. These two teams have a good history against each other. 12 times they've played in all over various tournaments. And it is Brazil that lead 7-5. And all that tells you is it could go either way. One of the deciding factors is likely to be that block from Pavan. Always good for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the first of probably several more to come. Steps in, takes the angle away. Great block. But also, what it does present is a very big picture that players can go off of. And that's a nice use of the hands. Let's get a good angle, a good view of how fast and flat that ball comes off the service. Melissa does well. Got to have the shots on the beach. The court having been made a lot smaller. Some of you won't even know that. For some of you who are playing beach volleyball, it's always been 8 by 8. It used to be the same size as the indoor court. That's well played by Pavan. And the reason the court was made smaller was to make it more exciting, to bring more action for the spectator. Look at that. That's one of those ones that could have stayed on the side of Canada, but as it is, they take the point. Sun beginning to make a little breakthrough. It will get warmer as the day goes on, which does mean with the gear that the players wear, particularly Brazil, they could get very hot very quickly. Cross court block signaled against Melissa, line block against Sarah Pavan. Oh, and that's going to work, and that's a really good view from that. So it didn't matter where Agata was here, she's still jumping into the cross, even though she was almost over on the other side, making cross seem the would be the other way. She stuck with it and went cross as she initially signaled, and the movement behind was to the line. So a break point for Brazil. We're back on serve. Oh, look at that. That's a really good play from Power. Not sure she meant it. This will have to come back over. Oh, again, oh goodness me. Well, that one was just one of those rallies where no one could really get the control on the ball they wanted. There was a swing chance there for Pavan, but she didn't take it, went with the pokey instead, and that really probably, maybe, was the reason why they didn't end up winning that rally. That's a really great get from Agata. Then she has a look, she knows where the blocker is. That's where perhaps Pavan could have had a swing, but she didn't really get out of the sand well enough, and in the end, it cost them. That's a great get out of the net, more reactionary than anything else, but similarly, brilliant reactions from Agata. A few deep breaths, that was an energy-sapping rally. Agata to serve. Brazil making that mini breakthrough, now leading by two. Agata coming through to block. Big hit from Melissa. Good reactions again. Great self-cover by Agata. Little change-up. Good touch. Duda deciding to break. And that one wrapped off the block and away. You get the feeling that there's going to be... It's a busy day at the office here for Agata Bednarczuk. 38 years of age. She's blocking. She's also being the player that Canada are going after in service. That's a lot of jumping she's going to be doing in this match. Duda now doing some jumping from the serving line. Oh, that was close. There is a challenge system available here to have a look at ball in out and various others. Decided to let it go. Certainly had Canada beaten, but they knew it was going out. Pavan now with the serve. Getting her long levers going to get through that ball on the jump. Fabulous hard hit again from Agata. We'll have an end change. Brazil holding on to their two-point advantage. Brazil were in Pool B. They beat France's Piacete and Ricard 21-11, 21-14. And then they beat Canada's Bansley and Wilkerson in 3-15-12 in the decider to get them through to round two. Good touch from Duda. Duda with a good look, but a great block from Pavan. She had a look to see where the defender was. Didn't really take into account where Pavan was. That's an excellent block there from Pavan, jumping into the space. Melissa to serve. Strong rotation this for Canada. They can really go after the ball from the serving line. Good up. Chance to get level now. Melissa will have a swing for it. That's an easy read by Duda. Oh, good dig by Melissa. Duda deciding to have a swing. Have another chance here. Duda once again. Lines available. But it's well read brilliantly by Melissa, who's working really hard in this rally. But now it's Agatha who'll have a swing chance. And she takes it with a little bit of help from the top of the net. Brazil get their side out. That's a cracking rally. Already both teams showing the quality that's got them to this semi-final, and the quality as well that sees both these teams will be going to the Olympic Games. And if you've just tuned into this one, I hope you're enjoying it. The sun's come out here. It was rather damp and misty, and I know it's pretty much like that, damp and wet around the rest of the Europe and parts of the world at the moment. Great swing there off the back of some wonderful defense from Duda. Full stretch and then up and able to come up with a brilliant swing. Much rather, I think everyone be happy sat watching this than having to deal with stuff outside, especially if it is a bit damp, misty and wet. Those of you who've got tents to put away or stuff in the garden to do, just don't do that. Just sit, watch and enjoy this and deal with all of those kind of things later. Brazil are dealing with everything at the moment. They're up 11-7. Who's cheering for Canada? Those cowbells you can see behind the players, that's what they're playing for. Well, at least a chance to get one anyway. Certainly the winner will get one. That's a wonderful block. But a really good break. The movement that the players make, all of that movement that you can see from Agata to get round the court, it's not easy on sand. Some of us, I mean, us mere mortals, it's difficult enough to walk on the stuff, let alone do what these guys are doing. So far, so good for Brazil. This watch major in Stade, so well represented, and unsurprisingly, it has got a bit warm, so off come the leggings. Is that a sign that Canada mean business now? I'm sure they meant business from the get-go. You have to serve tough enough against Melissa so that that doesn't become an option for Canada. Easier said than done again in that department. But a ball that you would think would go in towards Melissa on its way to Sarah Pavan would be one that would be difficult to try and put up in that spot. Whereas you're putting one to the outside, Melissa really likes that to her left. She can get a good platform and get a good angle to pop that ball up where Pavan can have a swing. Agata will serve, scurry to the net. Good touch, but not going to stay in play. Duda a little bit upset with herself with that one. That was a chance. We'll go to the technical timeout. Canada's run at this tournament, I mentioned at the start, if you're just tuning in, they lost to Spain's Alvarez and Lobato in Pooley. Then they beat Schoen and Stam of the Netherlands in 3-15-11 in this side. So that put them into brackets, winners bracket round one. They then beat Chantal Laborer and Sydney Tillman of Germany. That was 18-17. Then Margareta Kozak and Laura Ludwig to 14, then 22-20 in the second. And they made their way into the semi-final with a victory over Carolina Salgado and Barbara Seixas of Brazil. 25-23. For Brazil, it was plain sailing. Two victories in Pool B. They beat France's Piacete and Richard, 21-11, 21-14. Then they beat Bansley and Wilkerson to... they lost the first set to 17, won the next to 15, and then won 15-12 in the decider. They then beat Maria Antonelli and Talita Antunes, 21-19, 21-17. And then they beat Switzerland's Betschart and Hubeli, 21-18, 18-21, 15-13 in the decider in just short of an hour to make it to the semi-final. Melissa's serve, trying to make it tough for Duda. Oh, what a great roll shot that is. High hand, straight through the ball. Just a little bit of a cut, just very tiny, but enough to send it away from Melissa down that line. That man with some work to do. Well, sometimes you could argue that Pavan really doesn't hit the ball as hard as she probably should. That time, though, she makes sure of it, and that's a great swing. And if she hits like that all the time, then teams won't want to break on her. The trouble with Pavan is, and I say the trouble, that more often than not, she'll hit more of a softer, rolly-type shot, which can get picked up. But even so, not a lot of teams will want to go after her. This is one of those ones, wherever you are watching from in the world, whether it be Mexico or Madagascar, you'll be enjoying this. These two teams are going to be battling it out in the Olympics, not against each other to start with, but maybe later on. We're seeing just how good they are at the moment. This is the last event before they head off to Japan. Brilliant play from Duda. That's not easy as well, because you've got your right knee out and you're trying to play the ball back to your right. So everything's pivoting just on that knee, trying to keep your balance, core strength, so important. Good dig. Great movement into the cross by Duda. Good up by Melissa. That one doesn't make it in. Agata just stayed on the sand for a little bit longer in that rally than perhaps you would expect. She seems okay, though. Nice break. Excellent break. Got out of the eye line of Melissa, and then broke back where she couldn't see her, thinking she had that, she was going to then jump up for the roll, trying to then play it short. That was a really, really good, I can't stress just how good that play was from Agata. And we get to see them jumping from the serving line. Oh, well played, although a little bit one of those ones where Pavan was having to stretch, go on with the pokey, and Duda just... Watch Duda in defense. She makes that shift too early. Just if she'd have waited until the touch, it would have been right where she was. That's part of the fun of being a defender, if you like, is are you seeing what you think you're seeing? Are you guessing? Or are you actually making those good plays? Are you being patient? Patience is such an important part of being a defender. Making sure you've got that right information, but also knowing what you're taking away, the block and the defense, and then what your priorities are. If you're blocking line and taking cross court, what you're saying, yeah, we're giving that up, this is the first priority, there's a second, there's a third, that's not going to happen. Well, good play by Melissa. But it's advantage here for Brazil, and they've taken it. Duda with a brilliant swing cross court. 19-11, what a start. What an opening set this is proving to be for Brazil. But this is fabulous. See the way that she goes to sand, then moves herself forward to get to that ball as it clips the net. That's well played. Duda, thinking it was going to go across, took that step to her left and then wasn't going to get back in time to this ball that was played perfectly down into the other corner. Set point now for Brazil. Serving pressure has been really good by Agata and Duda. On Melissa, they've only allowed her to put the ball up once for Pavan to go on two. And part of that is they've been pushing her really deep so that she can't force that ball forward enough. And then what that's also meaning is Pavan setting the ball off the net, keeping Melissa a little bit further back. Seven side-out chances for the set. And Duda does it. First time of asking. 21-13, Brazil lead 1-0. This is how it's done. That's such a great picture. The way that Duda's able to contain that ball, taking that step with her left, the ball being passed just about on or in by her knee, where she's in full control, then continues her movement out wide and using that ball's momentum and going with it to be able to drift and swing on the line. Excellent, excellent beach volleyball. I'm not going to believe anything those stats have to say. They do say there's lies, damn lies and statistics. But certainly the top one is the best one, isn't it? One set to nothing. That's really all that matters. And the stats only tell you part of the picture as well. You could say, all right, there's a couple of blocks, only one block for Brazil, but they were able to channel the ball where it could be played and the defense happened around it to get to transition points. Those are really the important ones. How many transition points can teams make against the other team, and how are they doing that? Why are they doing that? What are their tactics around that? And then suddenly you see how the game opens up and there's so much more that's going on than you think. Canada up 1-0 in this second set, getting their side out. Oh, good cover from Duda. And then a great swing. And that's why Canada really want to go after Duda. She's got one of the hardest hits on the tour. You just wonder, don't you, after the Olympics is finished and we move into 2022-2023 season, Agata's going to be getting on for 40. Going to be thinking about winding down her career, perhaps. Who's Duda going to play with? Who's coming through? Is there another exciting talent of her around her age that could then go on? And you would think if there is someone that could dominate the tour for years to come. Well played, Agata. It's exciting to see and to think about the new generation of players that are coming through on the beach and when they're going to make their appearance. For most of the time when we watch these events, we're only seeing the top four, maybe the top eight teams, because we get quarterfinals and then semi-finals, finals that are televised. But there's so much going on, all the qualifiers, the country quotas, the pool play, and teams that we don't then get to see who are kind of making their way. There are teams that spend maybe 2-3 seasons going through qualifiers, not quite making it, maybe making it into one main draw. And then they get themselves enough points from doing all of that over time to eventually make it onto the main draw. And then the battle is staying in the main draw and traveling around the world. It's a tough slog. It's a hard graft to make it to the upper echelons and even onto the main draw of the World Tour. Such is the level. And then you look at these two teams and you look at Brazil, for example, 3-3 at the moment. Good touch. Another chance for Pavan. That's going to be put away with no trouble at all. But Brazil haven't been out of the top 10 since 2019. So that's the level you're looking at. No chance there for Duda. We'll have an end change. Not only have Brazil not been out of the top 10, they've gone in, they've had gold medals, bronze medals. They went to gold Ostrava, bronze Warsaw, gold in Tokyo in the test event for what was the Olympics going to be last year. So that's bodes well for them. They had a bronze in Vienna. They had a silver in the World Tour Finals in 2019. And then in 2021, they went on a five tournament podium streak. In Doha, they took bronze. And then in Cancun, in the hub event, they went bronze, gold, silver. Then they had a fifth in Sochi and a ninth in Ostrava. So a little bit of a dip in there from their point of view. Good movement, great footwork. Well read by Melissa. This could be a two-point advantage, but that ball doesn't find the sideline, trying to be too cute with the angle. And Brazil get their side out courtesy of an unforced error from Canada. And Canada, again, a team that are always there or thereabouts. They've had 10 top four finishes in 18 tournaments since 2018. I mean, that's incredible. Seven finals. They took four silvers, three golds. And then, interestingly, when they didn't make the final, they finished fourth on three occasions. So didn't even manage to get bronze. Big hit from Duda. Agata delighted with that. And Melissa getting turned by the ball as Melissa goes to defend this one. Off of that pickup from Duda, Melissa gets turned and her shoulders end up going away from the court. Really got to fight to keep your shoulders facing back to the court. See what happens. There she goes, gets turned, can't keep the one shoulder under the other enough to keep it back into play. Brazil now up by one. Very good turn to the line from Melissa. Which makes that look so easy. Well left. Brazil will be pretty pleased with the way the second set's going. You generally kind of expect that when you win a first set so comfortably like they did 21-13, that the other team are going to come back at you, come back at them, and up their game a little bit, particularly as it is Pavan and Humana Paredes. But at the moment, it's just going point for point, and the opportunities that Canada have had, they haven't taken. That, though, is a fantastic serve. That was pinpoint precision to the line. We got our first ace serve of this semi-final. Good up. Agata has a look, knows he's got the line, and that time out of reach of Melissa. Melissa having to swing off the net means immediately Brazil break, cover the court, and then they're able to come back. Super pokey that from Duda, right over the top of Melissa, who gets the touch first time round, but second time round, not quite the same. Another chance for Canada. A little bit too much on it. And the hard work for Brazil pays off. That's what defense is all about. Just keeping the ball alive. Great extreme touch. And then reactionary play from Agata just to get it back in play. And it's the unforced error that gives Brazil the point. Agata to serve. That's a bit tight. Pavan does well not to get into the net, but that left her completely out of the play. And Duda, with nobody at the net to block her, and only one person stood mid-court, there's only one outcome. Canada call a timeout. Just looking at the pools that these two teams will be in for the Olympics, Pavan and Melissa, they will have Heidrick and Vege Dupree from Switzerland, Suderburger of Germany, and Stam and Schoen of the Netherlands. And they've already played Schoen and Stam here in Pool E. And that was a close one, three sets. So it's a tough old pool, that, for Canada. You kind of think, oh, they should get through that easily, but it's not. There are no easy pools, really, despite how you might look at it for Agatha Duda. They've got Brandy and Bansley. They've got Wang and Xia of China. Then they've got Gay and Pereira of Argentina. And they also only just got past Bansley and Wilkerson, 15-12 in the pool here. So again, you kind of think when you look at the draws and the pools for the Olympics, oh yeah, these teams will be doing this and they'll be doing that. Easy to say, but it probably won't turn out that way. That's well worked, Melissa, just catching the fingers. So side out achieved, and now Pavan will go back to serve. Pavan's serving, the jump serving, doesn't look like she really opens up and creates a good twist to come back through the ball. A lot of it just seems to be jump pretty straight and then swing her arm through the ball. That stayed in play magnificently well. Oh dear, no one blocking. Suddenly Duda realises we've got trouble here. I better get in because there was going to be a free swing, and Melissa does extremely well. We'll go to the tech timeout. This is amazing. From that position to get that ball up and over and keep it in play. But advantage to Canada. And they take the point. Good block touch. Suddenly it was not quite so easy for Brazil, and it's Canada who've got a chance, but that's a little tight. And now advantage back to Brazil. Big swing, Duda! And taking on Melissa in that cross court with acres of line to go at. Confidence of Duda. Pavan couldn't quite get enough to throw the ball back down. But what a swing that is. Caught slightly at Melissa by surprise.
Yeah.
point for point, it seems at the moment, but advantage clearly with Brazil. They're siding out to go to a two-point lead each time. And if it carries on like that, they would be siding out to go into the final. All ifs and buts, still a long way to go. But again, Duda with a massive swing. Really good work by Melissa to keep the ball in play. Duda always committing when it's there to be hit. That's the advantage of being tall. As long as the ball's played high enough, even if it's too tight, you can get over. But although Pavan's not happy with Melissa at the moment, that doesn't bode well. You got any kind of animosity going on court. Maybe. Yeah, what do I know? Nothing. Maybe she's just saying, come on, I think we can get an ace here. And that's exactly what's just been delivered. That is as good as it gets. Oh, good hustle. That was put up perfectly. They knew exactly what was going on there. Melissa, for Pavan to have a swing. And Canada have wrestled the lead away from Brazil. Tennis court here in Stade, bathed in sunshine now. Getting an eagle-eyed view of proceedings. Top swing from Agata. She knows how to cut past the block. That was quite close to Pavan. I just wonder whether Pavan went more for height first than just getting straight across the net to close the angle. Doesn't matter how high you can get when you're blocking. It really doesn't. You could be one of the highest blockers in the world, but if you're nowhere near the ball, not getting close to it, then you're not going to close down any angles. Easy peasy for Sarah Pavan. That break's great, but you're only going to get, look how far that Agata can get. It's only going to work if they're going to roll a little ball short over the block and you're onto it. That works for Duda. Good hustle. That's great play from Melissa. What an angle she gets, but brilliant pickup from Duda. Has a little look. That's not easy. Oh, and Pavan brings the heat to the court with that swing. This is a fabulous rally. That's such a good cut on Pokey. Great ball control, which you need, so important. But look at that for ball control back to get the ball in play. And then a really well-timed block from Pavan. Okay. Interesting now, coming up to the business end of this second set. It's a must-win set for Canada. They have to do it. They can't not do it. Take it into a decider. But despite everything they have done, Canada, those moments, you know, the ace serve and the blocking and the hustle and everything else, it's still only level. And those are side-out points they're getting right now. This is going to go another couple of serves. Someone's going to make a break point, and then we're either going to take the match or take the set here, based on the way that this has gone so far. Oh, brilliant. That caught Canada by surprise. Agata able to have that swing from... Duda able to have this swing from that far off the net, and just... It's an easy point for her. Bit of pressure on Pavan. That's tight and low. Good touch chance. Taken. Brilliant play. What a great time to go after Pavan. And those are the moments that can define a match. But it wasn't so much. It was a great serve. But that's really good defense into a spot where all of a sudden you have got a swing chance for the break point. Duda goes back to serve again. A little bit of confidence, maybe a little bit of extra oomph on her jump serve here. Too easy. Too easy. But again, that tactic, which mentioned at the kind of start of this, they're pushing Melissa deep. So Pavan's then setting her off the net. And off the net, Melissa is not a threat as far as Brazil are concerned. And they are picking her off every time they've been able to do that. And now they have a two-point margin. Could be three. Might well be three. Should be three. Is three. And it brings up match point. That little surge just when they needed it. And it could well take them over the line. Canada have to side this one out. Another big serve. Well played, Pavan. She had a lot of work to do to get over to that ball. First match point is saved. Melissa serving. Two side-out chances for Brazil to book their place in the final. And they've done it! It's a gift from Canada, and it's the gift of a place in the final for Brazil. A straight set victory, 21-13, 21-18. Agata and Duda are through to the gold medal match here in Stade. Canada won't want to see this one again. Celebrating even before it had landed, they knew it was going out. They knew they were in the final. All smiles for Duda and for her partner. Here are the highlights. So the highlights, they don't really have the highlights. We're going to just see that celebration. What a great performance from these two. Solid first set was incredible. Second set, point for point for point, but that surge just at the end, just when they needed it to get themselves over the line. We can hear what they have to say.
Agatha and Duda, congratulations. The final here in Gstaad, Agatha, it's the 10th time that you're here. First appearance in 2005. And now it's your first final. How do you feel?
You always talk about this, huh? But it's true, it's true. The first time I was here was 2005, 16 years ago. I never won this bell. Oh, I won! Never give up, never, never. I played with Duda 3 times here, no? 3 times. And the first day that we played here, 2017, was so bad, our game was so bad, the tournament for us. And when finished, I cry a lot. And Duda wrote for me one beautiful paper. Partner, one day we won this bell. Wait. This is amazing for me because I play many, many places around the world. And here, I never have a good result. I know I have the final, of course, but won this semifinal for me, special for me, is very important. So thank you, everybody. Thank you for coming. Thank you. It's a pleasure. It's a really pleasure play here. Really, very pleasure. We are playing without public many times. We play our national tour. We don't have public. So it's very good feeling, this atmosphere, feeling the people here. Thank you a lot.
Thank you, Agatha. Thank you, Duda. Good luck for the final. Thank you.
A special moment. 16 years, no cowbell. She's going to be getting one, but what colour will it be? Which will it be? Will it say first or will it say second? I don't think she really minds. She definitely want to go for gold, that's for sure. But they'll have their chance. As she said, in 2017 they were fifth, in 2018 they were fourth. And last year, in 2019, when it was last played, they were ninth. This year, they're guaranteed first or second. Fabulous performance from them. We hope you enjoyed the volleyball. We have one more semi-final to come. That will be Latvia taking on Brazil. Kravesenoka and Gradina against Anna Patricia and Rebecca. That to come very shortly. We hope, I hope you can stay with us for that. But for now, though, it's time to say goodbye.
to receive on my left hand side. Enjoy the game.
Thank you, Mr. Arthur. In the room, we have some new tools that we can get out of the room. So, the Olympia Arthur.
Hello and welcome to Switzerland for live coverage of the Swatch Majors Stade 2021. Clayton Lucas here with you for semi-final number two as Latvia get ready to take on Brazil. Anastasia Kravchenkova, Tina Gradina of Latvia up against Ana Patricia Silva Ramos and Rebecca Cavalcanti Barbosa Silva of Brazil. Latvia seeded 10, Brazil seeded 6. Good idea in your picture for Latvia. What a tournament those two have had. And for Brazil, well, they've had a very good tournament. Obviously, they're here in the semi-final. A little bit of mist and fog around up in the hills. It is partly cloudy, but the sun has been out already in the first semi-final. It made an appearance and then stayed for pretty much the whole match. You expect it to be out again very shortly as it burns off some of that cloud, and as you can see on the court itself, it's fantastic. Well, that's one way to get an excellent view. Technology, it's so difficult to get those selfies at times, isn't it? One of the most iconic venues for beach volleyball around the world, this tennis center in Stade. Agnieszka Miszkowska of Poland is the first referee for this one, and it's Nina Hobi of Austria who's the second referee. We're going to meet the teams now.
Number 1, former under 18 and under 22. European champion, third appearance here in Stade. He's 23 years young, 184 tall. Welcome, Tina Proudina.
That comes Tina Gradina. She's won exactly $51,400 in prize money so far. And Anastasia Kravtseneca, 24, she's won $52,900 in prize money. Doesn't really compare to the other two. Anna Patricia, at 23, she's won $115,000, three career wins so far, six seasons on tour, 33 tournaments. And that comes Rebecca, she's 28, $120,000, three career wins, 32 tournaments, nine seasons. The six seeds may well be favourites for this one. However, the two teams have played before. That was in 2018 in Yangshu Pool A. Brazil did win that one, 21-13, 21-11, but that was a long time ago. That was when Latvia were coming out of the qualifiers to make it into main draw. Well, I'm sitting comfortably wherever you're watching from, whatever you're watching on. This second semi-final is about to get started. It's Brazil in green serving, it's Latvia in red receiving. Semi-final number two from the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour here in Stade. And the Swatch Major gets off to a good start for Brazil as they take the opening point. And they get it from block break point. However, as they were serving and it's 1-0, this is one of those break points that you could argue doesn't count for anything other than no more than a side out point, because if Latvia side this one out, which they do, we're now 1-1 and it's on serve, and it was as if Latvia had served first. Very nicely played that, right onto the line. And Patricia getting her bearings wrong with that one. Getting them right with that one. Very nice little cut. Just a little pokey up, quick turn of the wrist, get that ball down quickly, down on a sharp angle. Oh, what a serve that is, and it's an ace. Anna Patricia doesn't seem like she's quite ready for this match yet. Good dig. Great block. Anna Patricia making up for the fact she couldn't get the side out from swing. Makes it in the block instead. Up and across, it's getting close to that ball to close the angles. Another chance for Latvia. Yes. which they are unable to take. And Brazil now back level. Well, that's the big threat, the big element to Brazil's game that you've got to be careful of. Ana Patricia's just such a good blocker. That was a great serve from Rebecca. And just like that, Brazil have got going, and now they lead by two. Krasnoka couldn't deal with that ball. And now timeout called by Latvia. So well played. Latvia's 2021 campaign has started with a 25th in Cancun at the second event. Then they went fourth in Sochi, their highest ever finish to date. And then they went 17th in Ostrava, the tournament just before this one. In 2021 for Brazil, they went 5th in Doha, 5th in Cancun 1, and then a 17th in Cancun 2. That's all they played this year. That's a great serve from Rebecca. Krasnoka not dealing with that one at all. Rebecca getting turned. You can see from when you're looking at that and looking at Rebecca, where she's in a great position, but instead of being able to get one shoulder really under the other, to really contain.